Whenever changes are made to anything, there are always people who start by criticizing and listing the disadvantages. It doesn't matter whether you're shifting the kitchen table or reforming the university curriculum. People will complain. Now, I've worked through the reform of higher education more than once in my own department and in other people's departments. And I can actually endorse some of the difficulties that people complain about, because these difficulties do exist, and I'm going to talk about them in a minute. But in spite of them, I would still endorse the reform, endorse the change, and I'll tell you why. It makes work easier for the students, better for the students, but, and I'm an old soldier, it makes it easier for the teachers once they've made the change. Now, the first issue that people complain about in reforming education is the time it takes. And I think that I just have to agree with that. It does take time. You cannot examine the work you're doing, reform your courses without spending some time doing it. And in universities, of course, the first thing we shout is, oh, but it's my research time, I'm not doing my research. But if you think about it carefully, a lot of the research time that we complain about not using, we don't actually use it very productively anyway. Maybe I'm just speaking for myself. The other thing that we have to take into account of is staff resistance. People don't want to change. Some people are quite senior and they don't want to change. What do you do about this? Well, you help them, do the work for them, pass them your ideas and your learning outcomes, for example. Try and persuade them, work with them. But if push comes to shove and they still resist, ignore them. And there are another category which I think are more dangerous, and these are the ones who learn how to talk the talk, but they never learn to walk the walk. In other words, they'll talk about outcomes, they'll say this and they'll say that, but if you scratch the surface and look exactly at what they're doing, they haven't changed anything. Now, there have to be ways around that. And I think one of the important things is that you cannot introduce this reform without all the program tutors working together. And I think this last group who pretend will stop pretending once they work with others and they get the confidence from seeing how it's done properly. Finally, people say that learning outcomes are really difficult to write. Yes and no. What we're going to do in the next section is look at some tips and some resources which will help you to write really good learning outcomes and sequence them from easier ones to more complex ones.